Shalom Israel, this is Bishop Nathaniel. The Israelites have been scattered across the four corners of the earth, as prophesied in Deuteronomy, the 28th chapter. Here at Israel United in Christ, we need your help to recover the remnant of our people, teach them the gospel. Please help us, support us, and join or donate to the Booster Club today. Shalom.
Thing you're dealing with, you're going to continue to go through it, because if we don't turn back to God's commandments, because don't the world, especially the blacks, the members are giving to us, blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, everybody on this side. On this side is what God called us, and on the other side is what the world called us. You see that? On this side, God called us Judah, Benjamin, Levi, so far down. On this side, this is what the world called us, American black, West Indian, Puerto Rican, Haitians. That's what the world called us, but God called us another, right? Now, what you got? Read this.
The book of Psalms, chapter 147, verse 19. He showed his word unto Jacob, his statutes and his judgments unto Israel.
So the Bible said he showed his statutes, meaning his law, statutes, and commandments, his judgment for breaking the commandments unto Israel, to the people on that side. Read.
He have not dealt so with any nation.
He have not did that with no other nation. He haven't gave his commandments to no other nation on this earth but the Israelites, or so-called blacks. We the only people got God's commandments. Give me Amos 3. And for us breaking God's commandments, he only judging who? If you tell your child don't do something, he go outside and do it. Or she go outside and do it. Who you going to go outside and whoop your child or everybody? Your child, right? That's the same thing with God. He said we are his people. So when we disobey him, he gonna come punish us. Read this.
The book of Amos, chapter 3, verse 1. Hear this word that the Lord has spoken against you, O children of Israel.
O children of Israel, so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. Read.
Against the whole family, which I brought up from the land of Egypt, saying, you only have I known of all the families of the earth. Therefore, I will punish you for all your iniquities.
He said, we the only people he known. Therefore, he shall punish us for all our sins. Right. Now watch this. What is sin? Because God punishing the Israelites for sin. We are the Israelites. Now what is sin?
It says it in the Bible, doesn't it?
Yes. Let me see. Do you know?
Okay, the commandments.
The commandments.
And more things in the Bible also. It's not just the Ten Commandments, is it?
No, you're right. What you say, sis? What is sin? You don't know. I'm going to show you according to the Bible. You said it, said it. Watch this.
The book of 1 John, chapter 3, and verse 4. Whosoever committed sin, transgresseth also the law. For sin is. The transgression of the law.
Is the breaking of God's laws. The laws was given to who? The Israelites. We are the Israelites. That's what we are here to tell our people. The laws of God was given to us. He punished who for breaking them? The Israelites. Now let me show y'all the commandment. Give me Deuteronomy 22 and 5. Read this. Hold on. Go to Leviticus 11. We're going to come to that one. I'm going to give y'all some laws. I don't want y'all to take out running now. Don't take out running when I give y'all these laws. Because this problem is, we haven't been taught God's commandments. And that's why our communities are the way it is around the whole planet Earth. But we are here to teach God's commandments. Because we want to get out these conditions. You tired of working, sis. I know you is.
Oh, I like working.
You like working. Okay, you like working. But do you like giving them your money? Okay, then. What about you, sis? You like working? Nope. Do you like giving them your money? That's a gift. You like to do that. Right? That's something you like to do. That's a gift from God. I don't like to work. I'd be mad going to work. No, especially knowing that I'm the kings of this earth, and that this earth belongs to us, not just me alone, to y'all too. Also, read this.
The book of Leviticus, chapter 11, verse 7. And the swine, though he divided the hoof and be cloven footed.
What is the swine? What is swine?
Pig.
Pig, right? Read it from the top.
And the swine, though he divided the hoof and be cloven footed, yet he cheweth not the cud. He is unclean to you.
He is what?
Unclean to you. Of their flesh shall ye not eat, and their carcass shall ye not touch. They are unclean to you.
So what did that just say?
You should eat those
nasty.
What food?
Like the pig and
all. What did it just say right there? The swine, right?
Yeah.
That's the pork, right?
Right.
So God said we don't supposed to eat pork.
Right.
We in sin when we eat pork. You go in the majority of these apartments out here, guess what was in the refrigerator?
Pork chop.
You see that? You see that? That's the problem. That's why curses are upon us. That's why we're filling up the jail houses. That's why we're filling up the clinics. That's why we're filling up the hospitals. Because we're breaking God's commandments. Say, bro, come around. Let me talk to you too. Come around. Come around here in the front right here. I can't see you though. I need to interact with you. Let me holler at my brother.
You the main one. Get over here.
Did you hear that commandment, bro?
Yeah.
What did it say? What did he say about eating pork? You read it from the top again.
At the book of Leviticus, chapter 11 and verse 7. And the swine, though he divided the hoof and be cloven footed, yet he cheweth not the cud, he is unclean to you. Of their flesh shall ye not eat, and their carcass shall ye not touch. They are unclean to you.
So he said the pig is off limits to us. He said, don't eat the pig. Is that hard? What you say, bro?
Yeah, don't eat it.
Don't eat it. What you say, sisters, is it hard?
That'll give me high blood pressure.
You know why? Because you're not supposed to be eating it.
That's right.
Read verse 9.
These shall ye eat of all that are in the waters.
Now we talking about stuff in the water. We in Florida now.
I like fishing.
You like fishing. I like fishing too. But there's certain type of fish you can't eat according to God.
Yep.
Watch this, read.
These shall ye eat of all that are in the waters, whatsoever hath fins and scales.
He said, whatever in the water, the only thing you can eat in the water, it must have fins and scales. Do shrimp got fins and scales? No. What about oysters? Crawfish? Crab leg?
None of that.
None of it. Them catfish?
They the scavenger of the water.
I was just gonna say that. They are the bottom feeders. Yeah. They supposed to keep the water clean.
Right.
That's why the water look polluted, because they taking all the algae eaters out the water. Eating it.
We eating it.
No, why we eating it? Because we follow other men's ideas.
You see that? He on point.
The trap of the enemy.
Yeah.
The trap of the enemy.
Right.
So you know we're supposed to eat pork and shrimp, right? So you can't say you didn't know after today. Because judgment, if you know how the world is turning out, judgment day is approaching. That's why God sent out his prophets. Judgment day is approaching. You want the rulership or you want eternal fire? It's your choice. Give me Deuteronomy 22 and 5. Now, when you hear this law, don't get to running now. Because you we bring this law out to our sisters. Sister, I got to go now. Watch this, though.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 22 and verse 5. The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
He said, the woman shall not wear that which belongs to a man. Read.
What does that mean?
He said, a woman shouldn't wear what belongs to men. Do pants belong to men?
No, everybody wears pants.
Yes, they do.
Okay. Oh.
Well, I said, hold on, let me keep reading though.
The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man, neither shall a man put on a woman's garment. For all that do so are an abomination unto the Lord thy God.
Say it again, for all that do so?
For all that do so are an abomination unto the Lord thy God.
He said, for everyone that do so cross-dress are abomination to God.
That ain't all.
You better put some leggings up under it.
That ain't all.
So get what you're supposed to say, them pants. But listen, you got to have on a skirt. See what I'm saying? That's what I said. The thing, when you put on a skirt, you know what I'm saying? But God wants y'all to wear skirts and cover y'allself up. Not no skirts that's going to squeeze your body. Not no skirts that's going to show off your curves. You want to be modest. Read that again from the top, though.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 22 and verse 5. The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man. Neither shall a man put on a woman's garment, for all that do so are an abomination unto the Lord thy God.
He said, for all that do so are abomination to God. Now, how do God feel about abominations? Now, he said, a woman shouldn't wear pants, right? For all that do so are abomination to him. Now, this is how he feel about abomination.
The book of Jeremiah, chapter 44, and verse 4. Howbeit, I sent you to all my servants, the prophets, rising early and sending them, saying, oh, do not this abominable thing that I hate
That I what?
That I hate.
God hates to see women in pants. Y'all hear this? This coming out the Bible. So our sisters don't supposed to wear pants. And when they wear dresses, give me Timothy 2, you got it? When they wear dresses and skirts, because that's what y'all supposed to wear.
I'll teach them on that.
Okay, now listen to this. When our sister was in the cotton field, did they wear pants?
Nope. They had dresses on.
Where do we get the pants from?
A man made through life and generation, the one brought us across slavery. They wore stuff like that over here before we got here. Our nation.
And they pushed it on who? They
pushed it on us. And then, as a matter of fact, we might want to copycat. We want to wear it anyway.
We want to wear it. So, yeah. I'm going to show you. What he said was heavy. But I'm going to show you. Well, let me read this.
The book of 1 Timothy chapter 2 and verse 9. In like manner also, that the women adorn themselves in modest apparel with shamefacedness.
So he said the woman must adorn themselves, man must put on modest apparel. Modest apparel, meaning covered up. You want to be covered up. You don't want to see how you got your clean your right here. It's supposed to be covered up.
The revelation of that.
It's supposed to be covered up, sis.
The revelation of that, what he's saying is that, don't you see how women dying every day? The devil hate women.
What I'm saying is, sis.
Okay. Part of the reason why we dress the way that we dress is because we had to fit into a certain agenda.
Give me Proverbs.
You got to go.
Okay, but hold on, watch this. Let me show you what God said. Watch this. Let me show you what the Most High God. You got a proverb, and we're gonna go back to that.
I don't look at that like that anymore. But
But what did God say? Okay, so who you gonna obey, God or man?
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold, from Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone, 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.